I'll blow it up a little so you can see. The press designer laid these out so we could have people go to a date and think about what was going on in Chicago in a whole variety of places in 1795. And what you see is the Treaty of Grenville. This is when Chicago really becomes part of the American kind of system. It gives you the maps. We have to solve and things like it. But now I'm using the images, looking at the year from a variety of these perspectives. The other thing, and I just want to give you two quick examples here because these tie back to other, I forgot to resize this one. These are two of Michael Condon's maps. This is the growth of the built-up area in Chicago by time period. And what you can see is, with some exceptions, these outlying cities, that you really see the darkest area, the earliest area. You see that growth map that Burns and the University of Chicago people held so dear. But we also did this map in a slightly different way. And again, I'm sorry, this one isn't going to project too well. But this is the reason the towns were formed. So we have the satellite cities. This is now a map that looks a whole lot more like LA. You have your industrial centers, you have your agricultural centers, you have, and if you look at it this way, you don't get that huge sense of the city pushing out. But you do get a sense of all these little nodes, all these little areas, all these linked communities in a way that the LA people argue is part of a postmodern city, but most of these towns were established in the 19th century. So it starts to raise questions there. Now, this quickly, and I hope you can see, we had a graduate, one of our students do this, I'll blow this up. We had to do a couple entries. We used the also's the way encyclopedias always do. Where did the authors say the see also should go? When somebody read their story, where else should they go in the encyclopedia? And what you can start to see, this is just a handful of them, but I'll go to the railroads since the railroads were a big thing. You want to get a sense of how important railroads were for Chicago? Look at all the lines that go to the railroads. You can start to see this whole interpretation of the city in this kind of representation of the city also as in the information. Now, because this was all being done at the same time, we figured about how things would work in the print and the electronic version. The broad essays, the basic essays would be the same as would actually all the text entries. We added what we called galleries, kind of collections of images and historic objects. One of the things we saw the electronic version doing is be able to provide those kinds of primary sources that people could use to test what we said about Chicago. For interpretive essays, we had what we started off calling digital interpretive essays, but DICE seemed to work, so we called them interpretive digital essays, where people could have the kind of equivalent of the interpretive essay, but this time taking advantage of hypermedia and so on. We took maps, created bridge maps, we transformed the images into basic entries, biographical dictionary, still haven't quite resolved that. Business dictionary, the basic entry, what we use for sidebar, for primary sources, and a few appendices, we had a collection of appendices that were to be GIS representations of the space, so we could put this all on top of the GIS. Now, that didn't get done in the electronic encyclopedia because, and it's fair to say this, after lunch, you know, we haven't really talked about it all. This stuff is really expensive. This is two and